Hello, my name is Romain Fouché, and I'm in charge of drone development and new technology at the Cattenom nuclear power plant.
Hello, my name is Anthony Rampello, and I've been a project manager at the Cattenom nuclear power plant for the past 10 years.
I'm in charge of drone development and new technology to promote all these new technologies with a view to improving performance, agent safety, planning and financial gains.
I'm in charge of everything to do with non-destructive testing on the site. One of the issues at stake on the site is the safety of our agents who work there. As a result, we're going to have to work at height, and we're also going to have to use a lot of logistical means to access inspection areas that aren't necessarily at man height, such as scaffolding. There are also controls in capacities, sometimes involving risks of anoxia and falls from height. However, erecting a structure also generates other risks. You could very well drop a scaffolding bar or lose a bolt. These are things we don't want on the site, and the Elios 3 drone could help contribute. The added value of the Elios 3 is its speed of execution, meaning that we can get to the site quickly and carry out inspections. For example, the checks we were able to carry out this morning on the ASG tank were able to reduce the inspection time considerably because we don't have to set up scaffolding inside the tank, and we're able to carry out the checks with the Elios 3 drone much more quickly than if we'd been walking around on a structure. What's more, we realize that with the drone we can get into the smallest nooks and crannies, whereas with a conventional structure set up in one place, we don't necessarily have access everywhere as we'd like to. We saw that this drone could be very stable in the air, so we could get a quality image and then make characterizations or analyses on the image. The drone can also be used to take dose rate measurements, where it would be unnecessary to send someone directly to the site. The drone is also equipped with a UT sensor, so we can also take thickness measurements to guarantee the integrity or otherwise of a piece of equipment. In other words, we could carry out an inspection today in 2024 and then say that in 2 years' time we'll go back and compare the two images to see whether or not the integrity of the tarpaulin has changed. Inevitably, I see a financial gain, because if we don't mobilize resources to feed, for example, a 10-meter high scaffold, it's always something less to do. Let's take an example, the visual inspection of an in-house tarpaulin, 15 meters long by 3 meters in diameter. We could quantify the economic savings in terms of logistics, fewer people to carry out the checks, etc., at around 15,000 to 20,000 euros. Sending people is obviously an additional cost. What's more, these activities are outsourced. The advantage of having this drone at our disposal would be to perhaps re-internalize this type of inspection in order to optimize inspection time.
My aim today is to acquire this type of machine, even if it means sharing it with other sites. I'm also working with the Center Competences Drone, which brings together all EDF's drone expertise. I also work with other sites, so anything that's possible at Cattenom is possible at Tricastin, Belleville and Saint-Laurent.